The National Farm Machine Show is back in Louisville, Kentucky, and we are here for yet another year. Today we're going to take a look at the South Hall, and then tomorrow we're going to take a look at the North Hall, then we're going to go over to the West Wing, and then day four we're going to conclude our trip by taking a look at the pavilion. But for now, let's take a look at this very patriotically painted Patriot. And with that, let's go ahead and move on into the Kentucky Expo Center. 1.3 million square feet under one single roof. First thing we see when we walk into the South Hall main entrance is a large John Deere 9RX. Signs that we have very big things to see here very soon. As we move over to the entryway of the South Hall, we have a New Holland T7. Nice, dark, deep blue. And with that, let's go ahead and move on into the South Hall. Now, one thing I did want to bring up is that throughout the first section of this video, I noticed that portions of my voiceovers were being cut off. I didn't realize that when I hit record, I needed to pause just a little bit longer than what I was seeing on the camera as far as the recording starting for the mic to totally initialize and pick up. So I do apologize for that, but I do make corrections for that throughout the video. And then for days 2, 3, and 4, well, we've got that figured out and we won't have that problem going forward. Here we have the new CR11 from New Holland. This thing is a beast. Connected to a MacDon header. Holland booth. We've already seen a little snippet of the CR11. We didn't get a chance to use it too far up close to it because it is roped off, but it does have a pretty cool ground sensing MacDon header. We have a big old T9 655. Thank you. absolute beast of a machine. Tracks are probably about 5'9" as far as height. Drawbar hitch. And if you didn't think, round balers were huge. We have a New Holland round baler. Nice shot of the internals here. Festival net wrap. You can have yourself a New Holland Lego harvester. Yeah. Gill and Manitou booth. With some Giel skid steers and Manitou forklifts, telehandlers, here we have Manitou telehandler engine up close. Everything that's serviceable seems to be in very easy to access locations. So we have a 630, 737, 841. This would be the biggest one here at the show. With a set of bail grabs there.
So I call Lou and he can.
Then we have a 533. Telescoping wheel loader with a massive, absolutely massive bucket on the back, or should I say on the front. TYM, interesting brand for kind of smaller tractors. Be interesting to see this, maybe could eventually come into the game. It was one of their larger tractors that they have here at the show. Maybe more of a garden size tractor. Some of the TYM brush hog mower on the back. Here we have a nice smaller model. It'd be nice with a maybe an underdeck loader. This would be the T115 model. Dorf. We make awesome loaders. This company seems to specialize in loading equipment and other specialty attachments. We have an interesting demonstration here on some tilting bale loaders. Here we have a Landall B35 semi-trailer. And then the back end of this 7530 disc. LS Tractor, lstractorusa.com. It's always going to be jobs around the farm for these little deals. Thinking about mucking out those classic tight UK cow barns. LS Tractor. The largest LS tractor here at the show, with the LL8100 loader attachment. This is the MT-5 or MT-S73. You get in a camo skin. And not to be outdone, Case IH has also brought their variant of the New Holland CR11. The AF11. Because sometimes we just need to be a little less original with our naming schemes. Or how about a harvester made out of wood? That's pretty cool. An AF-11 made out of wood. IH Precision Disc 550T. We see it here connected to a 380 with tracks. And these tracks are probably at least 6 foot plus. And it wouldn't be a proper case booth, but a Steiger quad track. Sorry, not a Steiger. The Steigers have wheels, not tracks. This would be the 715 model. I do believe we're seeing a redesigned nose on this one. Then we have a little Maxim 150. Still, rear wheels, probably close to 6 feet in diameter. Great Plains has got a pretty big booth here. Every booth of the giant Jumbotron is awesome. Couple smaller drills. And then we got some bigger machinery. Yes, yes, yes. You see the John Deere banner in the back. We will be getting to that soon enough. We all love big machines. So we have the PL5905. You can pause this here and just take a look at the 5905 Flyer front and back. It folds up under 16 foot to transport. And for what everyone's been waiting for, that's right, John Deere's next. But we don't only have machinery here. We also have the only officially sanctioned John Deere tractor pull pedal car. Everybody's here for the John Deere loader equipment, right? Maybe a little Deere wheel loader, 204G. That's right. There's other stuff here that's actually green. I'll say a little loader. This thing has a huge bucket on it. Look at that bucket. John Deere 55 1M round baler. Complete with some full-size people as a frame of reference. It's connected here to a 5105M. Maybe a gator or two. Yeah. 6145M. Connected to a square baler.
This one?
There are the rear attachment that's going to flip it on its end, or its edge. When unloads. Crazy engineering of these knotters is just absolutely amazing.
Yep.
Here we have the baling computer, baling display, massive flywheel, keep everything running once it's up to speed. And a little closer look at the 6145M. R sprayer. We have a 410 8RX, conveniently with a nice dude standing there in front of the tires or the tracks to give you again a sense of scale. Now the 8RX, which we just saw and we're about to see again, is actually equipped with some saddle tanks. Thank you. Paybuster is another brand that I'd really like to see come to the game. Bell shredders of all sorts of types. Picker. For those who are still playing with stones enabled. Really interesting design. We have rock bins with our offering here at the show. A mock-up of their drying system. And then on the off chance that anyone doesn't know what an actual bin looks like on the inside, we've got a cutaway bin. With the air floor. We even have quite an international presence here as well. Various log winches and blades. Really interesting stand-on loader. Kubota's got a big booth this year, maybe as big as John Deere or Case. Everyone's favorite side-by-sides. Here we have the M7. pass to a Kubota round baler. Opened up so we can see the nice mechanics inside. And then beside that, we've got an M6. It's connected to a butterfly mower. And here we have an M5. We have the AGI booth. And we've got the 1539 Auger, Latco Auger built combination. Grain goes in there and then obviously shoots up. Here we have the new FX4 model, climbing up to 7,000 bushels per hour transfer rate. Now here at the GEA booth, we got our favorite angry tractor, the Dutes. Although I have to say, around where I'm at, typically the thing pulling the GEAs are gonna be the big fence. And we have it showing off its excellent terrain handling capabilities. Co, would that be how you pronounce this one? Specialized in mowers and other sorts of specialty attachments. This mower is quite interesting. It's got three decks that all independently float. And it can also fold up. Then here on the back, we've got several assorted small 3-point hitch spreaders. Some blades. Some brush mowers. And some vicious cutters here. And who doesn't love themselves a nice wheel rake? I'd like to see more of these come to the game, actually. If you're going to be using small bales, then you might as well use something like this, AE10 accumulator. You attach your baler right there. It would go up the chute, rotate itself around, and then find its way into this Plinko game, and eventually make its way into one of these four chutes. So then make it a whole lot easier to come around for the grabber. Grab those bales and load them up. Of course, they didn't have this 35 years ago. Would have been nice. Okay, everybody, let's play a game. What is this? Don't know? Let's find out. She's the Chrome Big X 1180 forage harvester. Opened up for all to see. A view we don't often get. Amazing engineering behind all of this. And yes, this tire is much, much taller than I. Oh, this control pad for manipulating the header here. Shows a fair bit of interest around Chrome, a straw harvest recently releasing. We have an arm to help you load your net wrap into the baler. Easy Collect 750-2.
Well, the buttons are running low on the shop button, so I need to start working to see if you'll do something. I don't know.
Then we have the square baler. Yeah, there's some apartments in New York City that are smaller than that bale chamber. You see here the twine coming in, going up, eventually to the Nodders. Can't reach up there. Storage. Of course, they have twine storage on both sides. There we have an additive tank on top of the flywheel. BKT tire. One of the tire brands that we have in game, of course. Showing off the various tire designs.
Makes it so great. It allows for the straight through shafts and belt drives that make the machine so reliable and efficient at transferring power.
And we've made it to AGCO. AG Revolution. Gleaner. Fent. Massey Ferguson.
It'll also allow for the distribution augers and the accelerator motors, which gives us the two stages of air cooling and increases the productivity of our cooling crew and provides for us that clean range and the natural flow process that makes all this stuff possible and only needs to pop up.
2850.
Road guidance. So one of the things we did here at Leisure was
53 horsepower.
Set all the different types of technology that are out there so that they can best fit what works on their farm. If the customer has a truly loyal system that they always use, we would have.
And here we have the Massey Ferguson 7S series. Is attached to a 1 series round baler. Again, opened up so we can see all the innards. Maybe the 7S isn't big enough for you. Over here at the 8S. Connected to the MEVF 1630 planter.
I was thinking, I wouldn't know why there would be an issue. Now I was going to talk to you. This is a guy, is this going to feel comfortable when you're telling him yes?
We want to hear about that.
Our 530 sprayer. Again, set up here showing off the terrain handling capabilities of this unit. Or maybe you'd be more interested in the greener variant with the Fent 934H.
it's back to the start. Okay. But you have to have your character. It helps it play the props with the game.
But come on, please. What's it gonna take? To get Gleaner. That's all we want. That's all we ask for. The S97. The classic galvanized look.
Something that you can use.
You don't run leveling on these, or all the other brands do run leveling on this.
Or the Gleaner header.
Gleaner's unique transverse rotor and accelerated rolls, and then some of these kits we put on for dividing the grain on the shoe, and we're able to cover these damn hills, drive them like a tractor just as.
But at least we have the Fent 10T. Again, one of the best parts about these shows is you get to see the interior of this machinery. Something that's usually not exposed to us as players. Yep, all these tractors have horns, as we can hear.
The table where they're at. I've probably learned that myself.
Fit 728 Vario. Set up with duals, front and rear. Vince Momentum 23 Planter. Here we can see another example of the terrain capabilities of this particular planter. Now we have the smaller version of this in game. This is the ZATS 4200, but we have the 3000 series in game. And yes, these are full-size people standing behind this thing. If you ever wondered why your tractor tips forward after you connect one of these to field fertilizer, well, it's because it's a lot bigger than one might think. A lot bigger. Because it's actually connected to a 1050. And we all know 1050s are huge. So if the 1050 is huge, the ZATS 4200 spreader on the rear is also massive. Again, there are apartments smaller in New York City than the inside of that spreader.
Do we need that one?
This one might have enough power to pull it. Fit 942.
Where did you guys get those cool hats from?
Tractor pull tractor. Here we have a Fent 1162 Vario. All that weight pack between the tracks. Drive over auger belt. This is what we definitely need in game for all those belly dump trailers. And they really, really should think about disabling the horns. Because apparently that's the fun thing to do. This is the Norwood booth. Selling several Quick branded products. Very large disc. Quick till, quick cutter. Salford spreaders. Discs and such.
Yes,
only the most appropriate mowers for the Mayhem crew. Bad Boy branded mowers. They even have some electric varieties, but for some reason I don't think electric mowers work for a Bad Boy Stigma. They even have some smaller tractors. And we have a small grain cart here. In the Brent, $13.98. Tract variant, of course. We're on the inside of a dry spread spreader.
It was laying on my work bench with a Nico one.
Rolling harrow with seed box. Seed and fertilized tenders. Liquid fertilizer directly in ground with the disc. After 2030 DT strip tillage tool. Big old tanks on the back. Big old blower. Twin tires. The Extreme 1119 grain wagon. That tire is, yes, over 6 feet tall. Apache HS 1100 self-propelled sprayer.
I'm
like it. I'll take it.
Okay.
Got a friend.
Mayer Manufacturing, made in USA, forage products.
That's kind of what I remember too, is like, oh, we want this type of what we're doing.
Just some small Deagleman equipment. And to get you a different perspective on the huge silage blade that we started with. There's the back of it. I think we've seen this a few times in game. The Procast 80 precision granular applicator.
Thank you.
You gotta get by the.
And then we have the Hardy sprayers. Nicely illuminated from the inside. Connected to a fine Dukes 6000 series. Here we have the smaller Ranger series, Ranger 2000 spray tank. And then behind, the familiar Navigator 4000. Sure would be nice to see Cat in game as a possible brand. Now the Wolverine that we see here is a ditching machine, and it is designed to engineer ditches through a field, and as it was described to me, it's going to allow kind of track lines to be put in so heavy machinery can run through those engineered ditches, and then it's going to toss dirt out either side. There also is a rather sophisticated rock catching mechanism, because as you can expect, this can turn into a rather deadly rock thrower as well. Somebody want a brush mower? I think Woods has you covered.
It's all mine.
Something else I wish we'd see a little bit more of are some more just normal, I guess, American style trailers, North American style trailers. Maybe Gator could come to the next farming simulator. Let me introduce you to the new Anderson Merge Pro 915 Merger. This thing is absolutely huge. the IFX 720 extractor. Sausage wrapper, as we so affectionately call it. Let's get a nice close look at these controls. How about a trailed Forager or the Deon Scorpion 300? How about Schaefer and their brand of loaders, their line of loaders, 3650T. T6680. It's long telescopic boom. Or the 5680T. The large 8620T, the largest one here at the show. That's a big bucket. Anybody ask for a sea tender from KVH, dual chamber, semi-trailer sea tender. Or maybe we need a supply trailer for our sprayers. Be great to see this come as an in-game standard item. I think we've seen another one of these earlier. Brandt Grain Dreck. Drive over unloader belt, perfect for belly dumps. And then the brand 1600 DXT. Or maybe a huge, heavy disc. H&S manure spreader, power spread 6138. Meridian fuel trailer. A seat hopper. You can have some nice tools in there and have a nice service trailer. And then if you prefer to handle your seed in boxes, for the Titan 2XT. Set your seed boxes on top. Then offload into your seeder. The Capello Diamant corn header. Be cool in game if we could see these fold up like this. For servicing or for transport. We had a good look at the underneath.
Had to put a new deck on it. It's fun.
Really something we haven't seen in game is the need for soil management, erosion management, and therefore the use of ditchers. Saw a ditcher earlier, the Wolverine. Here we have Hurricane, whole company whose purpose is manufacturing of ditchers. Welcome back to day two's coverage of the National Farm and Machinery Show. In day one, we took a look at the South Hall, and day two, we're going to take a look at the North Wing. We have a special guest that is going to be joining us very, very shortly. Raznak showed up at the show today and took a little swing at doing some color commentary as well. So you're going to see him here in a little bit. He gives a little bit of an intro as well. Then you're going to hear him later on in the video. I did record most of these segments before he managed to make it to the show. Don't fear, he will play a role in tomorrow's coverage as well. Let's get on with it.
Hello, everybody. This is your friendly neighborhood farmer, Raznak, with Farmer Klein at the National Farm Machinery Show in Louisville, Kentucky. Here, standing in front of one of the big monsters that everyone likes from the game, big old Klaus Harvester.
First up, we've got the Kuhn booth.
There's so simple ways they do it for us.
first bed PS242. Manure spreader. Vertical Max VT244 feed mixer. The VB560 round baler. You know, it'd be nice if we saw more of these available. Then we have Koons. Tube wrapper. OWR 6000. This is a reps 4x5 or 5x6 bales. Now Coyote was a brand that I didn't know about until last year coming to this show. Like a few other brands, they seem to focus on smaller tractors. As well as some side-by-sides. Coyote skid steer, TL750.
Yep.
one of the larger options here, the NS610. Really nice looking vehicles. Here we are at the Kinsey booth. Everyone loves blue. Oops.
You're
And then how about another form of green in Kloss?
Yeah.
Try on 740. This is the ASABE AE50 2024 winner for Outstanding Innovations. Yeah. And we progress from Klaus to Mahindra. I really think it'd be nice if we had more open cab tractors as far as options. That's all we ran 30 some years ago. Get out there in the heat and the elements. We don't need no stinking air conditioning cabs. Did you know Mahindra made Jeeps, or a Jeep variant, in the Roxor?
We're tough is a way of life. The land Mahindra is proud to call home. You see, tough is our motto. Tough is what defines us. It's in our spirit. And tough is a part of our mechanical DNA that's never going to change. But who told us it was time for war? So we listened to you. We listened to your customers.
It looks like an old school Jeep. This thing is super cool. I think they said 144 horsepower diesel, which is pretty wild. Turbo diesel, manual transmission, and we're just wondering why it's not in the game. Like we need stuff like this in the game, just to like race and.
So it's four-wheel drive with a five-speed manual, looks like. The McHale booth, brand we would love to see in game, I know. Integrated Baylor Rapper combo beast. Absolutely massive. Look at that pickup. Those cutter blades. The size of the drive chains, even. Storage for wrap. McHale orbital wrapper. and even more. Baylor Wrapper Combo Technology. This one with a bale turner. Flip that bale over, keep it from rolling. How about a bale shredder? Fairly prominent in the eastern half of the United States as far as dealerships. The McHale V6 760 round baler. $740 Brown baler. The $950 opened up for all to see. But before you can bale, well, you gotta put the product on the ground. And the only way to do that with a big old mower. Rear butterfly mowers. The McHale Pro Glide. Swap width of 51 inches to 106. Working width 358 inches to 378 inches. Three and a half tons, just the mower weight. Then you go with that, you need the front mower. Another 2,700 pounds on this one. Yeah. 3100 Pro Glide. From McHale to Milwaukee. Another mower forage product brand. Here's the ProCut 900 side mower. ProCut 320 side mower. And the ProCut 3000 TP trailed mower. For those that may not know, we get a nice up close look at the actual blades that these mowers use. Very, very short blades that actually free spin in case they hit anything. Extremely potent mower when it's coupled up to a 1,000 RPM PTO. Interesting little trailed spreader here. Ejecto. Here with a sprayer. Spraying the tops of some plants. And we have that spreader we just looked at. Boomalite, light use industrial equipment. Here we have a stand behind loader. Ditcher, attachment. Quadra Till, McFarland, HDL 1100 Harrow. How about the mother? The mother of all bins. The walkabout. WMB 4000 plus. Because it just keeps going and going and going and going and going and going. Oh, wait, I think we found the end. 4,000 plus bushel capacity. There are definitely apartments smaller than this everywhere. So anybody want a JCB? Maybe. I mean, it's not that big. 427 loader. How about the 525-60 load-all telescopic loader? Maybe that's a little bit more size. Maximum list, 5,500 pounds. Maximum height, 20 feet. Maybe a fast track's more your style. certified, fits three teenage girls. Really, I'm impressed and still surprised that there's so many high school kids that come to this show as officially sanctioned field trip. In fact, I was hearing someone say the other day that it's either you come to the show or you stay home. JCB 8330 fast track. Very, very big machine.
This is Raz here, and I honestly am starting to think that the JCB is the best looking tractor in the game. I mean, I'm sorry for all you red and green fans, but this yellow is just nice and fast.
Very, very, very bright here in the JCB booth. And to quote Hart, I am a warrior. Dude's far. V8280. Officially seats an entire family. The official Angry Tractor brand. And the 6230. Spray equipment, sprayers for all of your various sizes and needs. Here we have some smaller spot sprayers, brush sprayers. Small trailed spray tank, 500 gallons.
So this is the best control
I move over to the liquid applicators, putting liquids directly into the soil. Or maybe we just need a supply trailer. This trailer has two huge tanks. Room in the middle for a pump, other spray equipment, and then a rack for four totes.
Here, stay here for a minute. I'm going to get a bag.
Looky here, we got a horse. not a lot of stuff from Horsch, but they do have a presence here at the show. The Mestiro 24SXL, I'm sure I butchered that like I always do. But up close you can really, really get a sense of the scale of how robustly built all this machinery is.
Yep. Yep, keeps things down.
A sense of scale for the steel. Where's my hand? I'm sure some will ask what these are. These are spacers that you put in to limit how far down the hydraulics are allowed to travel.
Yeah.
And we have our mirror.
Yeah.
Recently added to the game, but I do wish we had more equipment like this 504 Pro. Or the perennial star of the show, the ZR5 1200 self-propelled round baler, which is a really interesting design because it basically has 605 round baler attached to the rear. And at last year's show, I learned that you could actually detach the round baler module and, in theory, attach a different one.
Project.
Possibly the world's first zero turn baler. And then here we have the internal computer screen. Amazing visibility. With a center pickup. The R1022 wheel rake. The VSR 410, sorry, the VSR 440 feed mixer, and the TM105 trailed mower. The versatile 620. with Cummins X15 engine. Maybe something a little bit smaller, just a little bit, the 365. Filters for very easy maintenance. Now the flyer said the largest cab in its segment, and I have to agree. This thing definitely has a very big cab, very wide, spacious, roomy. Cab's nearly the full width of the tractor. Over there we have the 210. And the H52050 Fury disc. The TSM V8000 seater. Your front seat hopper. And then we have the NovaCat 351 front mower. It is attached to a Fendt 933 Vario. On the back of that, we're gonna have some Pottinger butterfly mowers.
I set up the show just to make the connections.
Right.
Okay. So it's kind of one of those things that if you are locked in on a racing.
NovaCat V9200. Something we see a lot in real life, but very rarely in game, especially for console players, would be one of these round bale lifts. Transport round bales from field to farm. So often we see these being used to transport a bale or two at a time. When farmers store their bales alongside the fields. You got a slurry pit? lets a Lagoon Crawler X do the dirty work. Or the better spreader. They do the dirty work so you don't have to. We're not even going to try to pronounce this brand. They build grain cleaners, separate the grain from the chaff, quite literally. Because of course, when we talk about cleaning grain, we're not actually washing it. The functionality we've seen come in the form of select mods. It's the use of an ag bag. It's horizontal forage storage. Love to see this come as a standard feature. You're going to dump your forage in this hopper. And then on the back end, it's going to be fed into a bag from this end. Bringing a long semicircular tube. Not unlike the bale tubes, bale sausages, as we affectionately call them, but instead of being actual bales, it's compressed, compacted, loose. Now, I saw a case yesterday over in the North Hall. Got another little section, Case IH Farmall 120M Super. Of course, we recently had the Breed Case IH pack, including the classic and modern Farmall celebrating the 100th year. A Farmall 2023. This is the RB456 round baler. Yeah. case construction loader. From all 75C. Fourth loader. Fifty to 64 horsepower. Or maybe a baby farm all. Lots of attachment options. GTS harvester headers. Challenger 4245. I don't know how long this thing is, but it's awful long. Well, it says flexor 50. Could it be 50 feet? I wouldn't doubt it. They're the J&M Speed Tender, Seed Tender. And then flanked on either side, some large J&M auger wagons. A wheeled variant. And then the tracked variant, the RX 1432 series, sorry. Here we have a display of the various tracks and track widths. And what makes our track system unique? Keeping to the header trend. Another brand, this one with some extreme terrain following headers. Take a look at that. Or over here. And then they have a mock-up. And I have to say, if you've got field with this type of a incline, you're probably going to be having an issue with any traditional header. Here we have the same header from behind. So it's at least a 3 foot incline in the center, if not more. And then the grain variant. Iron Craft mowers, attachments. That basically concludes the segments that I recorded before Rasnick showed up, and now we have the musings of an absolute madman. Hope you all enjoy.
Look at there, we got a King Cutter log fork. It holds a log. That's more than what can be said with some of the things in the game. We have Walker out front mowing, you know, because the mower's out front. That's Klein's joke. I mean, it's when you want to pull and look good doing it. It's for all those wet fields out there. We got the Hydromax trencher. This thing is huge. I mean, this massive machine. Like, it just makes you feel little. And that's saying a lot for a big guy like me. I'd love to see more stuff like this in game. I don't know about the rest of y'all, but it definitely would be cool to be able to manage like stuff like this. When you like your girls to be big and fat, right there, nothing like some big fat tires.
I guess every day has to have at least one John Deere shot. So here it is, the token John Deere shot for day two. Stop your whining.
We're being watched. They know we're here. We're being watched. They even have air support.
Come on, buddy.
For the low, low price of $69,500, you could own a 1988 John Deere 4250. You know, if you're collecting things. And, you know, if red's more your style, you got the old International 1566 Farmall. Both beautiful, beautiful tractors. Oh, it's just beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. International 1566 Farm Hall. You can buy for around $55,000 as it sits. Look at that thing. That's just beauty. If you've ever been in the market for something called a Wacker Neuson, Craig Mile Farm Equipment. Yeah. We found it. We found his inspiration. GTX's inspiration here at Thunder Creek Farm Equipment. It's so crazy. In game, these things look so small. In real life, you just realize how massive everything is.
Hey, everybody, and welcome back to day three of the National Farm Machine Show here in Louisville, Kentucky. Today on our intro, I thought I would just do a time lapse as we walk from the south wing entrance all the way over to the west wing. Give you a little sense of how large this place truly is. Let's take a look here at the map real quick. We'll see where we are based on this star. Then we're gonna be walking all the way up and around Freedom Hall over to the West Hall. And that's what we're gonna focus on today. With that, let's get to the hike. Let's just stop, take a look. This cool little diorama that's been set up. We got a cotton harvest going on. Somebody's down in a ditch. That's probably Tukey. Oh, we even have a running river, real water through here. Let's zoom in on that. Oh, we got somebody braving the rapids. Got some hay work going on. Cattle operation going under the road. Not
Grain harvest. And with that, we continue our hike. A little sneak peek into the tractor pulling arena through a security gate. Now, Raz scouted this yesterday, said that the West Hall is mostly set up for cattle operations. Get through here before it gets busy. We got Raz, we got Cowboy, and you know, you never have enough knives. Or how about, we saw a drone yesterday, but this would probably make people run in terror if this was flying over in the other hall.
It's a sprayer.
We have a spot spraying drone from DJI, the drone people. Pretty darn cool. Drones in ag are not just used for capturing pretty shots of tractors or farmers in the field. We're using drones for real life applications.
That's the refill trailer unit, the dock rescue. Yeah.
Command and control trailer. Info video about the drone. It even has horseplay built in. There's the T10. Thank you. or the T40. Overall, pretty neat. Rotomix feed mixer. Nice American brand. Or how about one built on a truck body? That'll cut a ditch. I wonder how many horsepower this single furrow plow will take. I don't think Tukey can hook this up to his Porsche. This is obviously going to be for irrigation.
Stuff like that.
We have a real trailer. Sprayer tanks. All sizes and types. Saw a trailer similar to this on day one, I believe. We've got framework there for IBC tanks. Hayes seed tenders. The West Hall seems to typically have some of the more smaller brands. Same type of machinery, same types of things that we've seen previous days in the larger halls. Just smaller brands. The booths on these tertiary halls are a bit lower cost. The battle axe. Definitely want to stay away from this thing. Side discharge. Crop shredder. What a small brush mower just isn't enough.
It's a cornstalk windrow. Yeah. Cool.
Well, I think it's, well, yeah. Yeah. Now we have APV in the background. We've seen them in game, specifically around grass care equipment and cover crop planting. So we saw AgBag yesterday. You might think to yourself, well, once you get it in the bag, how do you get it out? Well, this machine is going to basically roll that bag up and then shoot that material into a trailer. That's pretty cool. Actually, this one is a loader. The other design was an unloader. So this is a skid steer front, but it's like grass work, but then you can reseed with it. Cover crop deal. Skid steer attachment seater. The all-rounder. Gravely. The Alice 3400. Side by side. You can never have enough side by sides. Truly. This is where the mowing gets tough. It is a seriously neat piece of machinery. And then we have the Boss service trailer. With the inclusion of grapes and olives. And we have another brand focuses on orchards and such. There's a sign for everyone. Signs and hats. Hats and signs. Come on. Aero quip. Cattle loading, sorting, management. On the go. Cedars. We have a trail variant. And we have one here attached to a skid steer.
What I got works. Yeah.
Jet grain trailers. We have a seed treater. It's going to take seed from a big tote, process it, and then deposit it into another tote. Auger belts. And again, something that we really, really need in game for all players, including consoles, is something like this to help offloading with belly dump trailers. Something so you can truly drive over, dump onto then another auger like the one that we just saw. There are mods, but sadly they are PC only. Pressure washers of all types, sizes, and capabilities. Seed tender for the large seed totes. The Semez. Here with a small booth showing off one of their mowers. Service trailers abounding in various brands. Mentioned yesterday, it's kind of ironic, they all seem to land on the same general shape and size, but you know, when you find something that works. Maybe your vehicle didn't come with tracks, but you wanted to convert it over. Maybe mat tracks. Convert any vehicle over to a tracked vehicle.
Come here.
What if we had one of these? Puffed up to Farming Simulator. How about a DJ? Put that in your studio. And speaking of tracks, how about this classic Cub Cadet track lawnmower? Or the natural resting place of a John Deere up on a lift. Seedway, grain loader, grain tender. Feed trailers. Ashland graders, scrapers. This one's attaching on the front of a skid steer. We need more skid steer attachments, because clearly everything can be attached to the front of a skid steer. East grain trailers. Hitches, hoses, more irrigation equipment, pumps, drainage. There we go, pumps and hoses. We need to be able to put pulleys in. That should be able to pump some liquid. ...700 to 900 horsepower. No, we didn't get an opportunity to go into any of the tractor pulls. It doesn't mean we can't come in here into the pits and take a look at some of these fine pieces of machinery. Blue blazes. Lock and load.
bottle.
Triple bypass. Here we are being weighed for the event to make sure that we have the right weight spec. Get her done. About the tail end of one up close. High maintenance. Tinker toy. That's right, there's three engines under there.
Sorry. Okay.
Money pit. I mean, that's only the drive shaft right between your legs. Nothing to worry about there. Cornfield Cruiser. Lessons learned. Model working grain tower. And speaking of skid steer attachments, we just have an abundance. Like I said, we need more. Should be, can it attach to a skid steer? The answer should always be yes. Three-point hitch wrapper. Some smaller tenors. How about a miniature round baler? Trailers. Again, these things are things we'd like to see from the standpoint of North American players. trailer bodies, truck bodies. Your post driving needs. Attach a stool loader, skid steer, or maybe you need a dedicated post driver, self-propelled variety. Imagine if instead of drawing fences, we had to drive each post in and then connect them. Here you go. These tires are huge. This tank is huge. And we have the Blazer 1725 auger wagon. I can't even get far enough away. Get the whole thing in a shot. These tires are 800 by 65 by R32. Silage blade, anybody? We saw a big silage blade day one at Diegelman. This blade definitely rivals that. The pit bull. I gave you the dimensions of that other tire, of the tanker. We're talking about 900. 65R32. The Tube Line BF8000. This is going to be a bale unroller, if you will. Not so much a bale shredder, but it's designed to basically unroll the bale. Here we have a product shot showing it in action. Bucket in a bucket, showing you the different sizes and its construction. We have Archon brand products. The Artex manure spreader. Here we have another one of those grain baggers to fill an ag bag full of grain. This is an auger. See if I can get another shot of this. I think this is going to be what you're going to use to empty that bagger as it collects in the plastic up on the reel. Let's do a shot of the other side. How about rocks? Here's a brand we can add. Focusing on rock collection and rock care, rock removal. The Spartan. And then the rock collecting bucket. How about a three-section brush mower? Batwing mower. Triolet, I think is how you pronounce it. Bean mixers. Day three, and your John Deere tax has been paid. It's connected to a MacDon FC3012 horn header, demonstrating a flexing of capability of 15 degrees. Up to 61 inch deflection. Similar to the header we saw yesterday. We have the MacDon FD245 header. Up to 17 inches of flex on this header. It's sold in 40-foot, 45-foot, or 50-foot lengths. How long is this one, do you think? Small square bale loader. Loads two bales and then flips them. Very interesting setup. Bale grabs and then darling for small bale players in game, you're accusing multi-pack. What brand is this? Well, it's no other than the Penta brand from our good neighbors to the north. Specifically, we were looking at the inside of the Hurricane. 40-30 feed mixer. We have to show the 20-30 compost mixer. As well as some more feed mixers. Of various sizes. Then a V8610 push wall trailer. Across the aisle from Penta, we have Landall.
Didn't know it, yeah. He's probably recording me right now.
Uh-oh.
How you doing?
Hi, YouTube.
It's been a great time.
It's been a wonderful time here in Louisville with Farmer Klein and Cowboy. We We definitely need to get more people. I might like go into a seizure with these LED strobe lights flashing over.
I'm not showing them. I'm not putting in a seizure.
You're not gonna show me having a seizure. But no, definitely a good time. More people should come.
Now, sometimes I think that the game, when you unload a trailer, it unloads unrealistically fast. This trailer claims the ability to unload in 55 seconds. Let's see what we got on the inside. I think it's going to be a movable floor.
I don't know. If it's just all
through. Oh, yes, it is. Or maybe you want a Spartan. The Intimidator, side by side. Trinity trailer. Agvax for slurry sucking. You definitely don't want these pumps clogging up. Now this is one heck of a conveyor. The year of the drone.
Solid belt.
Not all drones are airborne. the Bale Baron, another square baler stacker. See how this thing operates. We'll check the machine out. Input. And then it's going to collect and stack all of those square bales. Wrap them in twine. And then come out the back. Or then the baler to then run into the Bale Baron.
Sorry, where'd you pick that up?
Oh, yeah.
It is one heavy duty baler. And then once you have your bale stacks, nice bale ground. Forget about spraying. How about just wiping your weeds away? No worry of overspray here. Attach this sponge to your spray bar and then just apply the weeds. Lily has a small booth here. Discovery 120 Collector. It did something that I saw last year and had no idea how big this thing really was. Here we have the feeding robot. Here we go. We have the shell of what is perfectly capable of becoming a excellent farm sim simulation rig. Just connect controls, some sort of controller, add some screens, and off you go. Thank you. again, with the skid steer attachments, we need, clearly, we need far more of these in game.
Here, I can give you a variety, but you know, guys, you might never use them.
Then maybe we can do a challenge. Skid steer only. Can you farm with only skid steer? In real life, it seems like you can. Because there's attachments literally for everything. In game, sadly, no. You can't. This is definitely the year of the drone. Last year there were a few drones at the show. This year West Hall seems to be inundated with the drones. And this is by far the biggest one I've seen yet.
And folks, that is a wrap for our coverage here of the National Farm and Machinery Show for 2024. I was thinking all along that we had a fourth building to take a look at, or a fourth segment of the Kentucky Expo Center to take a look at, but it turns out we do not. We covered the South Hall, we covered the North Wing, and the West Wing, and that is the entirety of the show. I'm going to be making plans to come back here in 2025. I would love to meet up and talk to you all, maybe get you in the video, and we can explore the show all together again next year. Till next time. Happy farming!